This really sucks. Because of that betrayal, I'm all alone now. And in order to stay in this game, I had to resort using such dirty tricks. No, it's all your fault, Hitmo. You deserve that for betraying me. What now? Hey, Hitmo, so you were here after all. What?
What do you want?
Don't look at me like that. I promised it you, didn't I? You can now join our alliance.
Really? You are actually allowing me to join?
I would be a heartless bastard if I didn't. You did even a better job of provoking Scraggy. Now that he's gone, there is no one left to abuse you anymore. Come with me, I'll introduce you to my alliance member.
You sure about that? I mean, I'm fine with it, but what about them?
They agreed to my plan beforehand, so I'm sure that they'll accept you warmly.
Right, I'll come to you soon.
So it was Vaporeon's fault after all. If that catfish didn't approach Hitmo in the first place, I would have been in this. But you just dug yourself a grave, catfish. You think that I am that stupid Hitmo, but the truth is, I will be your worst enemy. I'll destroy you and your alliance from inside. You'll regret crossing paths with me ever again.
Alright, I think there's something I really should talk about.
What is it, Chespin?
It's about that dream.
I thought we agreed to each other that our dreams should be private.
I ignore that, but what if Darkrai actually pulled us a prank and put us in the same dream?
No, I refuse to believe it.
Then tell me what happened in your dream. It's better for us to find out the truth, isn't it?
Aren't you supposed to be with Marsh Tom today?
Marsh Tom is with Mero today. I left them together on purpose so we can talk privately. Will you keep denying the truth or face it straight on for it? It's up to you.
I know for sure that earring gang I saw in that tree was not real.
I initially thought that as well. But if we are not going to be honest with each other, then other campers might take advantage of that. I admit that I like you for it, but it's better for us just to be friends right now.
I think so too. I'd want Vaporeon to know that we are just friends as well.
What's your deal with Vaporeon? He has nothing to do with us.
That might be true, but look at what he did in the last 2 days. He teamed up with Scraggy and us to eliminate Weasel, then did something else to make Hitmo backstab Scraggy. Even now he is most likely planning his next move, probably targeting one of us.
I don't think Vaporeon would do something to us. He might target Maractus or someone else, but I think that he doesn't see us as targets right now.
You seriously don't know Vaporeon?
Then tell me something that I don't know.
All I know is that he is some kind of strategist and a very clever person. More than any other, he wants to win that ultimate game of strategy. That's what exactly he is.
You don't have to be repeating yourself, Ferret. Ferret knows something else about Vaporeon, and she doesn't tell me. I know for sure that Darkrai brought us together in the same dream, but I didn't want to hurt her feelings, so I chose not to insist any further. But she can keep up that long enough. Eventually, truth might come out in the moment where she is least prepared for it. And I don't want that to happen. I hope that she can understand.
Well, Mashtomp, would you like to tell me more about yourself?
There's nothing else to talk about.
Really? If that doesn't work, how about you tell me about your younger days when you were still a mudkip?
Oh, those were really amazing days in my life. I had lots of fun and made a good amount of comrades. That Rupert and Trevor came on the island with me and... Oh, it seems like I went over my head.
No, you definitely sounded like that mudkip on the very first day.
Really? I just did?
That's right. I think I told you that yesterday, but... What matters is not how you look on the outside, but what you are on the inside.
What are you talking about? I mean, you have changed too. You're not the same cry baby that we saw back in the first day.
I actually am. The truth is, even though I look different, I still feel so weak compared to many others. The main reason why I no longer cry anymore is because I already cried for so long that my eyes ended up being dried up. And that's when I realized that crying for help in a place where I'm all alone won't help me at all. So I simply decided to stop crying. And that's my story. And the same is true for you. Weeping for all that you have lost is not going to help you either. So why don't you stop being sad and just for me? I want to see you smiling.
You are really something, Mario. But why the sudden interest for me?
I can answer that for her. you got turned into marshstone because of Buizel, and later on you can visit help on the camp to eliminate him. Buizel was the member of our alliance and also our friend. So how are you going to make up for what you have done? Maractus, were you listening to us? I thought we were left alone. How I can leave you alone? Someone has to watch over you, after all. But marshstone was watching over me all this time. Isn't that right, Marshy?
Yeah, kinda so.
Well, it's good that you have another friend right now, but don't drop your guard. There is no telling when one of us get targeted next.
Don't worry, I'll make sure that nothing bad happens to her, I promise.
What? Marshstone, you?
Oh, did I really just say that? Never mind, it just went over my head.
You're so funny! Oh gosh, those kids. Well, at least it's good that someone else can take care of Mel. That means I can stay more focused on the game. I know that Vaporeon is up to something again, and I might be his next target. There is other alliance too. And Diggersby's next challenge. It seems to be impossible to prepare for everything.
Everyone, let's celebrate Scraggy's elimination. The drinks are all on me.
Yeah, whatever. One less pain to deal with.
Why are you not happy?
Why I should be? We are still in the game. Diggersby still have more trick in his sleeve. Don't you remember what Mafia said last time? There are going to be even more injuries.
I think we'll be just fine.
Yeah, she doesn't want us to die after all, isn't he? And bad guys like Espo and Scraggy are already gone. What could be worse?
This is Diggersby we're talking about.
How long you are going to keep grabbing like that?
It's just my way to shrug off all the bad things that happened to me.
But you are missing out some good things on the way as well.
Nothing from what happened to me so far can be called good. Yes, even meeting you. Pidgeotto, you are still one big joke. Laudet, you are a lot better when you were still a Wismo. And Dorian, the way you talk is just simply annoying.
That's not the way that you should be talking with your friends.
Friends? Sorry, but I just listened to your lesson that friendship is impossible in this stupid game where you compete for money. We are not friends, we are simply an alliance, which by the way was founded by that Dorian over there. So the moment we reach a certain point on the game, we'll be probably backstabbing each other's throats. If Diggersby doesn't force us to do that already, right on the next challenge.
Radicat, you can't just throw this off.
See? Even Dorian admitted it.
I don't want to talk about future challenges and betrayals. I believe that right now we are here, together, talking with each other, with not any intent of backstabbing. And I wanted to keep it that way, if possible.
Yeah, that would make the most sense.
Whatever, you just see how wrong all of you are. It's just a matter of time.
Radicat, please come in the main hall in 10 minutes. Don't be late. Diggersby.
To be honest, Radicat is actually right. I have lost my interest staying in this alliance. I would have rather joined Marshstone or Yimolga, but all my actual friends ended up in different alliances. I should have asked Yimolga and Marshstone to form an alliance with me while I was in the same team. I am not feeling myself to be comfortable within my own group.
What's up everyone? Today I'm going to present to you another special game. A game of lies and deception. In that game, some of you will be forced to lie and deceive in order to win today's challenge.
See? I told you! He's going to break us up!
Will you stop interrupting me, right again? I haven't finished it yet. So, in this game, the four of you will be deceiving and killing others, while the other nine will help to find and lynch the deceivers.
Killings and lynches? You're talking about something really extreme.
Oh, I'm just talking about another party game.
What kind of party game would force us to kill other people? Explain this to us!
Well, the party game is called Mafia, and it is exactly what you will be playing tonight.
Mafia, you say?
Yeah, you will be playing the game called Mafia. In this game, four of you will be randomly chosen as Mafia, while everyone else will be chosen as Town.
So what are the game rules? How do we play this game?
Don't worry about it. I can explain to you everything about this game. It will take me about 30 minutes to explain each and every aspect of this game. But right now we are short on screen time, so...
Those of you who are watching this show right now, press the pause button in the next 10 seconds and read the rules. Once you can understand the rules, you can resume watching the show. Thank you! Now, after I finally explained everything to you, do you have any more questions to ask?
It's actually not that difficult as it sounds.
I understand the game rules.
Good, so there we have four mafia, one of which is a roadblocker, one sheriff, one doctor, one vigilante, and the remaining six will be just ordinary campers. If the mafia team wins, all four of them gain immunity. If they lose, everyone else gets immunity. So do your best to win. You certainly don't want to be the one responsible for your team's loss. Remember, anyone could be your enemy for this game. To trust or not to trust? That will be the most important question. Now, we will give you your role cards. Do not allow yourself to reveal your role card to other players, or it will completely ruin the point of the game. Your role card can only be revealed if you die. Pay respect to the game rules and do not violate them, or else you will be disqualified from the island forever.
So that means no outside interference.
That's exactly it, Vaporeon. I'm glad that at least you can understand that. Do you have any more questions? Nope? Good. We can proceed with the game. Close your eyes. Now, the contestants who have received the Mafia role cards. Open your eyes and take a look at each other. The four of you are now teammates in this game. You must get rid of other contestants during the game and work together in order to win your immunity. Have you recognized each other? Good. One of you is also a consort who can roadblock town power roles. Remember that person. Now close your eyes. Sheriff, open your eyes and identify yourself to me. Good. Close your eyes. Doctor, reveal yourself to me. Good. You can go back to sleep. Vigilante, you might be the most important role in the whole town. Good, I can see you. Close up. Alright, all roles have been set up. You can begin our day discussion. You have 3 minutes. Go!
So, what are we supposed to do in this game?
We are supposed to find among us 4 people who could be mafia.
I can call up suspicious people beforehand. They would be Third, Vaporeon, Marshtomb, and Hitmore. What's up with those random names?
Yeah, those descriptions are completely wrong. I'm not Mafia.
Leave her alone. This is just her usual rambling. She's not serious.
I'm always serious. You think I'm joking, Lordred? Oh, it's simple, Dorian. It's written on their faces. Just ignore her, Vaporeon.
I won't ignore your friend so easily. Do you remember what he has done in the past 2 days?
Vaporeon is very intelligent. He should be able to help us fighting any mafia.
Unless he is one of the mafia himself.
That could be true, but the only ones who are more suspicious to me are Reticat and Hitmore.
What? Why those two?
Reticat is probably just acting like that to make us ignore her, and Hitmore.
Yeah, I don't like this guy at all. He burned me so many times. I could fight Scraggy on equal ground, but I would always lose each time he brings out Hitmore.
Hey, I was just following boss orders.
Well then, who is your boss now, Hitmore?
My boss? I don't answer to anyone but myself now.
I'm not sure why, but I feel like Hitmore has changed a lot. Yeah, it's like we are talking to a different guy right now. What? You won't reward him right away, Dorian? But why? I don't like doing this.
What? Are you going to back off? You just listed him as one of the suspicious people.
Yeah, but screw this. I'll do just Dorian says. I'll vote Hitmore.
Hey, are you serious? Why would you vote me now?
Why not? Besides, if you are not mafia, can't you at the very least defend yourself properly?
Even you, Vaporeon! What is the meaning of this? I thought we were in alliance.
What?
Alliance?
Oh, now you've done and said it.
Vaporeon, what is the meaning of this? Why did Hitmore mention alliance?
He meant our actual alliance from the game.
After Scraggy was eliminated, I invited him to join our alliance. Pachi and Demoga already knew that. But you didn't mean to tell this to everyone else, Heatmore. For that reason, I'm going to vote you down.
Yeah, I'm voting him too. Even if he won't turn out to be Mafia, we won't feel ourselves bad about it.
Hey, I'm not fine about it. Why even my own alliance members are going to vote against me?
Because alliances doesn't matter in this game of deception. Our goal is to find out anyone who acts with suspicions.
And you have been more suspicious than anyone else.
Just leave me alone.
That's not a response of someone who would not be Mafia. You're not even helping us to find any.
Attention everyone, your discussion is now over. It is time to cast your votes. Out of all 30 people here, one person will be voted down to be lynched by others. Vote one who you think might turn out to be Mafia. Now everyone, cast your votes. In 10 seconds, we'll find out who will be the first person lynched in today's game. Now, reveal your votes all at once!
Uh-oh, this is not happening.
Yeah, this is exactly what will happen right now. Everyone has decided to lynch you, Heatmore. Now please stand yourself in the middle of the stage.
There is a question. How is Heatmore actually going to be lynched?
Well, the answer is very simple, Raticat. Have you heard of mob lynch? All you have to do is to unleash all your moves on the victim at once.
Really? We can beat him up for real? Wow, this will be so fun! Not for a person who will be going to the gallows next.
Hey, what is the meaning of this? Diggersby all!
May Arceus have mercy upon your soul, Heatmore. You can start now!
No, help! Someone, please, stop it!
And so, Heatmore has been lynched. His role was mafioso.
Yes, we did it. Take that, you bastard!
Silence! We are now entering the night phase. Everyone, please close your eyes. Now, Mafia, open your eyes. You are down to 3. Pick up the target that you want to kill. Thank you. Also, Consort, please a target that you want to roadblock. Okay, I got you. Go back to sleep. Vigilante, wake up. You must now pick a target to kill. Thank you, I got it. Sheriff, who do you think could be Mafia? Pick a target. Thank you, go back to sleep. Doctor, you need to protect our innocence from Mafia. Who needs some healing? Oh, I see. Thank you. Welcome to the next day phase. And it appears that they have some first casualties. First up, Dorzion is dead. His role was Kemper. Next victim is Vaporeon. He was also killed tonight. His role was Mafioso. The second day is now up. You may begin your discussion.
Yes, the Vigilante actually did it!
I can't believe my eyes!
Wait a second, I don't get it. How Vaporeon turned it out to be Mafia?
Because when Heatmore meant alliance, he didn't just say it about his alliance with Vaporeon. He actually slipped that he was Mafia together with him.
Really? But he wanted him down.
That's because Vaporeon was frustrated that Heatmore slipped an important fact right in front of everyone else.
Then we just have to find out who the last two Mafia are.
I think we don't need to. Someone already figured their names, isn't that right? Marsh Top and Furret.
What? What is the meaning of this, Pidgeotto?
You don't get it, Kratigat. Was this actually the names that you call it for? Vaporeon, Heatmore, Furret, and Marsh Top.
Wow! So she is actually a psychic? Not exactly. She actually made a weak attempt to defend Heatmore when Dorzion called for it, but immediately after that started to agree with him. Why?
Because I didn't like Dorzion at first, but at some point, I realized that he was right.
So, between Furret and Marshtom, who do you think is more suspicious?
I would say Marshtom. He hasn't said any word at all.
What do you want from me?
See, he started to respond like Heatmore.
But I am not Mafia! What is the meaning of this? I haven't done anything!
Yeah, that's exactly it, Marston. You haven't done anything at all in this game!
Hey, do you seriously believe that Marston and Ferret are the last Mafia?
What? Are you going to cover up for your alliance members?
It's not like that. I just don't see Marston as suspicious. Maybe Ferret, but definitely not Marston.
I think that actually neither of them would be Mafia. I think that the most suspicious ones are Radicate and Picciotto.
Well, look who just talked. But you're wrong. I'm going to prove to everyone that I was right. So I'll start with Marston. Is anyone with me?
Yes, I will.
We're trying. Only two of them left. We don't lose anything much.
Hey.
I also think that Marston is worth checking out.
Maratus, you're not seriously going to vote him?
Yes, I will.
You are wrong, comrades! I am not Mafia! Don't listen to those three!
Let's do this as well, Patchy!
Fine.
Hey, we're not fine with it. Marston was standing right near me.
I'm not fine with it either! Marshy didn't do anything bad before!
Listen, kid, it's not a matter of what you have done before that. We are participating in a dangerous scheme. You should be glad that you are still alive.
But I'm not ready to see this! Radicat, it's all your fault!
Don't worry, Mario. You are not alone.
What if Marston doesn't turn out as Mafia?
Then we'll just switch back to Radicat later.
I heard that.
Comrades, it's not fair. I'm just an ordinary camper like you. Please rethink about it.
Time up. We are now entering another voting phase. The person who ends up with more votes than anyone else will be lynched. Just like Hitmore before. So prepare your votes. Now, let's just wait for a dramatic moment. Review your votes!
It can't be happening!
Yeah, this is exactly what is going to happen. Marston, by the order of majority, you are now guilty. Please step in the middle.
I can't look at this!
Do I really need to do this?
You may do this, or may not. But everyone who have voted guilty on Marston so far has to do execution themselves. Do it for the town!
Hey, comrades! Don't do it, please! Stop!
Well, in the end, most of the campers, apart from Mayu, chose to partake in the execution. And for what? Marston was just an innocent camper.
No way! What you have done?
Sorry, Mayu, I thought.
What a disaster!
Be quiet! Another night is coming. Close your eyes and prepare for another thrill.
So, clean us those bodies while the lights are off.
You don't mean?
I mean, take them to where Manaphy is right now.
Just for your information, no one likes you anymore.
Oh, I'm sure they'll change their mind soon. Now it's time for Mafia and other rules to make their turns.
Mafia, wake up! You are down to two now. Pick a target to kill.
Thank you. Consort, which person you are going to roadblock?
This one?
Okay, I got you clear. Close your eyes.
Vigilante, pick a target to kill.
Thank you.
Sheriff, pick a target to check.
Good, now close your eyes.
Doctor, pick someone to kill.
Okay, you're good. Dismissed.
Another day, another death. This one here is breathed body of Maractus. Her role was Vigilante. And the other one has also died. Ymolga, her role was just a camper. And with that, we're moving in the next day. You can talk again.
Ymolga, I can't believe that. Who did that to you?
I think we already know that answer.
Maratus, I can't believe it. She was a vigilante.
Yeah, and she also was the one who killed Vaporin.
But why she had to attack Ymolga? I have no idea. Maybe because that squirrel wanted to lead the next lynch right on me.
I think that's exactly why we should do that.
What? What is the meaning of this, Low Dread?
You were the one to let us to lynch Marston.
But you were the one who reminded us those names of yours.
So what now? Should we try to get Radicate?
No, I think we should actually go for it.
I think that one we should go now is Loudred.
You serious? But why?
Trust me, we should go with him.
Trust you?
Come on, do you really think that I would be in the same team as Napoleon and Hitmore?
I guess not. We all saw your surprised face when Napoleon went down.
Pachi, don't do it! You'll regret it later! Trust me and walk first instead!
Sorry, Ratty Cat, but trusting you, especially under worse conditions, is near impossible. I'm not even sure that you are on our side.
Out of all of us, the most suspicious are you three, Loudred, Pidgeotto, and Ratty Cat.
Why? Is it because all of us push it for Mashtong?
You just said it. Loudred is innocent! Don't involve him into this! I think it's actually Fred and Pidgeotto. Hey, why you have to involve me all of a sudden? If there could be at least one Mafia among us, it probably has to be you. But Fred is way more suspicious. Mayo, will you help us to vote for it?
I am not sure.
Loudred, who do you think is more suspicious?
I think it could be Mayo or Chespin.
That's ridiculous.
It's not impossible. There is a possibility that you can be a Mafia Chespin.
It has to be Fred! Fred, Mayo, are you with me? We are going to vote Loudred.
I'm not Mafia. Look somewhere in the other corner.
Don't try to divert the discussion from your corner. Leave Loudred alone. Guys, we need to consolidate our votes on Fred so that Loudred won't get himself lynched. This is just wrong.
You are the one that is wrong.
Everyone, can you just stop and listen to me? Your discussion is now over. It's time for judgment. There are 7 of you and 2 Mafia alive. With your luck out of the game, you have only one room for error. If you mislynch 2 more times, the game will end in the victory of Mafia. So choose your voice wisely. Alright, your 10 seconds are up. Reveal your votes. It's 4 versus 3, but the one who is going down is Loudred.
No! Mayo, you could change your vote to Fred.
You are the one who told your group that I could be Mafia, so no hard feelings.
And with that, Loudred is going to be lynched by mob once again.
I can't believe that they actually did it!
Lynch time!
This is not the end! My teammate will avenge me!
And he's down for looking. Loudred's role was another mafioso.
Seriously? I never thought that would actually be true.
Good job, guys.
Night time. Don't interrupt my brilliant coaching. Go to sleep. Come on, come on. Consort, you are the last standing member of the Mafia. Pick up the person that you wish to kill. Okay, I got you now. Who do you want to roll block? Action confirmed. Go back to sleep. Sharif, it's up to you to find the last Mafia. Okay, we have your action. Go back to sleep. Doctor, wake up. Pick your target. Thank you. Go back to sleep. Wake up, everyone, and look closely.
But Sharifu!
Yeah, the last Mafia got Pachi, and his role was Sheriff. That's all for it. Discussion time.
So he didn't point out Loudred on an empty point. He probably knew that Loudred was Mafia.
Yeah, and at the same time he wanted to keep his role hidden from them.
I almost feel sorry for this guy. I mean, I was trusting Loudred this whole time. Me of all people. Right before the game I said that I should not trust anyone.
I think I can understand you.
What can you understand?
Wait a second, guys! I think I figured out who might be the last Mafia!
Oh really? And who that would be?
It has to be Chespin! I know for sure it has to be him! You are trying to be all quiet, but now it's time for you to speak up!
I see, my eyes have been finally opened, so we'll go for Chespin!
I don't like the sound of it, but I'm fine with it!
But I am not fine with it! There is no way I would be a Mafia!
Really? And why that would be?
Because I am a doctor!
What? Chespin, you are actually a doctor?
Yeah, I am. So what now, Pidgeotto? You thought putting blame on me would work?
Oh, so that's how it is. Wait a second, who did you protect last time?
I was on Ferret for 3 consecutive nights.
Chespin?
I only did what I felt was right, Ferret. I had no idea that Pachirisu was a sheriff.
I got it now, Chespin, but it has to be a etiquette.
Say what?
When I say it, I mean it. You're the last Mafia. Who else would try to defend Loudred?
Big talk for a bird who can't properly fly. You are the one who jumped to hint about Loudred.
So did you. But still, there are two others, Mayu and Ferret.
What did you say about me?
Mayu is innocent. If she were a Mafia, she would have voted out Ferret instead.
That's right. She has to be either Pidgeotto or Raticate. At this point, I'm sure it's Pidgeotto.
No way! You are the one who proposed that everyone should vote Marshall. You are very bad!
I'm always bad, Pidgeotto. Don't interpret it in the wrong way. I'm always in the bad mood, and you're making it even worse.
So which one is more suspicious?
I think it's actually Pidgeotto. I actually think that the last Mafia is Raticate.
I'm not sure myself, but it has to be one of them.
What is to talk for? Pidgeotto is Mafia!
No, I am not! It has to be Raticate! Just look at her face!
This is going nowhere.
Time's up. Sorry to interrupt your conversation early, but it's time for you to cast your vote. Four town members versus one last Mafia. And one last chance for a mistake. Will the game be decided today? Review your votes now! What an end! The one who's going down is Pidgeotto. Come in the middle.
What? Hey, I understand Mario and Raticate, but why you, Chespin? Why you had to vote me down?
Because I felt like it was the right choice to do. Besides, even if we are wrong, we can always try again, right?
Lynch time, don't hold yourself back.
Oh well.
No way!
Oh, I never stop enjoying that. Now, up to review. Pidgeotto's role was an innocent Kimber. You're all losers.
Say what? Oh no, this is...
Night time. We are entering in the final night. Close your eyes. Now, consort, open your eyes. Who do you want to kill? This one? Okay, and your target for roadblock? I see. Thank you, and close your eyes. Doctor? Yeah, I got it. No questions asked. You may turn back. And we're down to three. Tonight we have lost Mayu. She was just an innocent Kimper.
What? Mayu? I thought for sure that Mafia would kill me. Why am I still alive?
Well, maybe because you are not the real doctor.
What are you saying?
Well, he actually is. No one has contacted him so far, which leaves only one person left.
Raticate, it is you!
So you were Mafia all along. I was right three times in four. Don't listen to her, Chespin. It's fairly obvious that the last Mafia is Raticate. Who else would easily agree to lynch Marshall? Who desperately tried to defend Loudred? It has to be Raticate. She is lying! She left you alive on purpose so that you two would vote me out together! Yeah, that's exactly what you thought. So you had to kill Mayu and leave Chespin alive in order to frame me. Why would I have to kill someone like Mayu? I have no idea. You're always acting against common sense.
Hold on a second. So does that mean I actually have to choose which one of you is the Mafia?
That's right. In this kind of situation, you have a 50% chance to fail miserably. The chance is greater than 50% actually.
You mean that he will fail with more than 50% chance?
No, I'm 100% confident that he will succeed.
Really? What makes you think so?
Now listen, Chespin, right now it's not a matter of who gains immunity. What matters right now is that regardless of who will win, if we lynch Raticate, then she will lose this game for sure. I want to eliminate Raticate from the competition. But if you lynch me, she will win immunity, along with that Hitmore, Vaporeon and Loudred.
Hey, what is the meaning of this?
So how about it? We can easily convince our group to eliminate Raticate from the game.
That might be true, but what I can gain from this third?
Well, after this game ends, I will tell you everything that I have experienced in that dream, Chespin.
You really do? Are you honest with me, third?
Yes, I do.
What kind of three dreams are you talking about? Oh, I get it. You two are in relationships with each other. We are just friends. Third, I think I'll do just as you said, but only because I believe that you are town. If you are really Mafia, then you played a good game. But right now, I believe that you are town.
Time's up. There are only three of you left. One Mafia, one Doctor, and one Innocent. The entire outcome of this game will be decided right here and right now. In just a few seconds, we will find out who gets to win the precious immunity. Now, review your votes!
Crap! I just lost against a power couple!
And the last person to get lynched is Raticat! Now, before you reveal your role, you can choose between two kinds of lynches, ferreting or rabbiting.
Ferreting or rabbiting? None of them sounds good. I don't want to be ferreted, especially by ferret.
So you chose rabbiting? Very well then. Bunnelby, do your job.
It's fun!
Wait, get down!
Rabbiting is certainly more enjoyable than ferreting, and the Raticat's role was an innocent camper. That means the Mafia team has won. The last Mafia was ferret in the end.
What? You were actually a Mafia?
Sorry, Chespin, but I had to get an immunity myself first. I really wanted Raticat gone. Don't worry, I'll keep your promise and tell you everything.
So that dream was true? You really saw me there as a human?
Well, I have to keep a promise, no matter how embarrassing it is, so yeah. But I did what I did because I thought it was a dream, and I just played along. You did the same, aren't you, Chespin?
Sure I did, but do you really think that this can bring us even closer?
I'm not sure, but one thing is true. I really like you, Chespin. I admitted that already in the dream.
Yeah, I love you too as well, but we have little screen time left, so off you go, prepare for another elimination. And here is the detailed role list. As you can see, Ferret, Vaporeon, Lowbred and Hitmore knew each other and were working together in this game, supposedly. Those four gain an immunity, while everyone else is for grabs.
I actually wanted to expose Vaporeon's intentions and make him lose that immunity so that everyone could vote him off. But because of that ferret, we both gained immunity this time. More importantly, there is another threat looming for me. I can't get anywhere close to Diogeon, else he would figure out that I am not the actual Hitmore. I want him gone, but I just have to follow the leader. His next target is not so bad.
This was an unexpected game, especially from Ferret, but during this game I have learned something important. Watch closely how the events would unfold.
I don't have anything against Raticat, but Ferret is right. She is getting on everyone's nerves and should go down.
That's it! I'm leaving this alliance from today. I'm going to vote for Raticat. Sorry, but you start to annoy even me.
Yeah, I pretty much figured it out. Everyone who is not on my alliance is going after me. Well, I had no chance of winning from the start. If they want to drop me out, then fine. I started to get myself sick of this island anyway.
Welcome to the another elimination ceremony. As you might know, Ferret, Hitmore, Lowbred and Vaporeon have an immunity today thanks to Ferret Sweets, who have won the challenge. The rest of you are at risk of elimination, but let's turn our elimination into something different this time. First up, let's start with ones that have no votes. They are Pachi, Emolga, Duogen, Mail, Mashton, Martus, and Pidgeotto. Our last two are Chespin and Raticat.
What? I'm in bottom two again?
Of course you are! I still have something like my lands. Not that it matters to me anymore.
I should matter you a lot, because this time our elimination will be somewhat different. Just like in Mafia game we just played before, before I announce the person to be eliminated, all of your votes will be revealed at once. Chespin, you allowed the Mafia to win just for the sake of getting yourself closer to Ferret and getting rid of Raticat.
How you can say it like that?
Because that's how I see it, my point. Meanwhile, Ratika, you've been on nerves of everyone. You're getting into my nerves as well. You're so negative that even you believe that you better be off this island.
Oh, come on, don't add insult to injury.
Now, here comes another dramatic moment. Who will be eliminated and who gets to stay in this game? Review your votes now! It is done. The person who gets eliminated is Chespin.
Great, now I have to stay in this island for longer. Not happy about that.
What? What is the meaning of this, Ferret?
No way, Chespin, they actually chose to eliminate you, but why?
Vaporeon? You did this, aren't you? Your entire group, including Hitmore, voted against Chespin, but why? Explain yourself, please.
It's pretty simple. He was just getting in my way. Besides, he was a threat to me as well.
Threat? What I did to you, Vaporeon? I don't understand.
I'm pretty sure you do.
Is it because I threw away the game for a third?
Oh no, how could I forget about him?
Third, I've been itching to ask you, what was your problem with Vaporeon?
I completely forgot to take him into mind. Vaporeon was my previous boyfriend, and now he chose to eliminate Chespin because he was jealous.
What? Wait a second, Ferret. You were in relationships with Vaporeon before?
Yes, Chespin, I was, but we broke up shortly after a certain incident. No point mentioning it anymore.
I guess I should live quietly.
Chespin! Marshtomp, we're going after him.
Pidgeotto, did you just try to walk me off?
Yes, I did. I'm leaving your line starting today. I'm a free bird now.
I can't believe it. Does my journey end right here and now?
Come on, I can't believe it actually happened.
It was all my fault. I was worried about my own safety and completely ignored yours.
It's fine for it. What matters right now is you finally getting honest with me. After all, there shouldn't be any secrets between friends, right?
So you still treat me just as friend, Chespin?
I think we are more than just friends. Marshtomp, do you remember that Everstone that I gave to you?
Everstone?
Yeah, if you are still afraid of turning into something like Swampert, just keep it with you. It should save you from any future worries. And I heard that you and Melula are getting really close to each other.
Oh, I just met her recently, comrade.
I hope that one of you wins this game. Too bad I couldn't play a bigger role here. But at least I'm glad that we managed to save Yumonga back then. Good luck to you all. I hope we get to see each other once again. Especially you, Ferret.
Farewell, comrade.
Marshtomp, I think I have made a decision. We have to include Mayo and Maractus in our alliance as well. I know there are thoughts of Vaporeon. Are you fine with it?
Sure, comrade, whatever you say.
Well, that was quite a shock. I mean, who thought that they would eliminate Chespin, the human turned Pokemon? Oh well, as the game host, I don't have anything to complain. It'll just make the future events all the more interesting. How Ratika is going to respond to Pidgeotto's betrayal? Does Vaporeon have some more tricks in his sleeve? And will we actually see another couple in the future? Find out in the next episode of Total Pokemon Adventure Island. That's all for now, folks.